Hi, welcome back my dear students. In our previous session, we discussed about motion and about the devices which the force applied on one part is transferred to another part and used for motion. Today, we are going to discuss about gears. Students, do you know what are gears? It is the interlocking of corrugations on the lids that enables one to rotate with the other. Such wheels are called gears. Students, where have you seen gears? Yes, you are right. In vehicles, toys, handles, etc. Do gears bring about change in the direction of motion? Do they bring about change in the speed of motion? Do you know about that? By making use of the rotation of one part of a machine, gears help us to set in motion more than one part of a machine at different speeds and in different directions. When a big wheel is turned using a small wheel, the speed of rotation decreases. When it is reversed, that means when a small wheel is turned using a big wheel, the speed of the rotation increases. The use of gears can bring about changes in speed and the direction of motion. We make use of this advantage in number of machines. So students, now I am going to give you the recap of the whole chapter along with motion we discussed so far. First, we discussed about motion. Rotation and revolution are the motions of the earth we are familiar with. The earth has two types of motion, that is rotation and revolution. It rotates about its own axis and revolves around the sun once in a year. Due to these motions of earth, we are always in motion. Then first we discussed about circular motion. The motion along a circular path is called circular motion. A toy train running along a circular path is given as an example for that. The next one is linear motion. The motion of a body along a straight line is linear motion. For example, lift going up and down. The next one is rotatory motion. The movement of a body about its own axis is rotatory motion. Rotation of a fan is given as an example. The next one we discussed is oscillation. The to and fro motion of a body about a mean position is called oscillation. For example, motion of a swing. And next we discussed about vibration. Fast oscillations are called vibration. Tap on a stretched rubber band using a finger, we can feel vibration. Let us discuss some examples for action of force on bodies at rest and bodies in motion. The first one, bodies at rest are made into motion. Example for that, an arrow is sent from the drawn bow. Next one, moving objects are brought to rest. Example, vehicles are stopped by applying brakes. The next one changes the direction of moving object. Example for that, a fast moving cricket ball is hit by the batsman with the bat. Next, increases the speed of moving vehicles. A cyclist applies more force on the pedal. It is the example for that. Decrease the speed of moving vehicles. Drivers apply brakes when the vehicles goes down a slope. It's an example for that. So students, these are the important points we discussed in this chapter along with motion. Study it well. Thank you.